Good morning students, Saira. In the previous video we have started a new chapter, that is India, and we have learned few points about the India. And in today's video we are going to learn more about the India, about its location, its physical features, and about its states and union territories. So before that, I will give you a quick recap what we learned in the previous video. So we have learned that India is a land of diverse land form. Mean the earth surface of India is covered by the different land forms. So what are the land forms? Some areas having mountain range, some areas are plain, some areas are desert, and here some areas are plateaus and some areas are coastal areas. Means the areas which is near to the sea is called coastal area. So India is a land of diverse landform. Children, tell me, which country is the seventh largest country of the world? My question is, which country is the second largest country of the world? Very good. India is the seventh largest country of the world, and its population is second largest in the world. It having around 135 crore and 26 lakh population. People speaking here more than 23 languages, and many different religions were found here, like Hindus, Islam, Christianity, Sikhim, Buddhism, etc. And we have learned that about three main seasons. And what are they? Very good. Summer, monsoon, and winter. And we have learned about its time period. Summer start in March or April, and it end in May or June. The rainy season is start from June and it's remain till September. And winter is start from October to February or March. Then we have learned about the neighbors country of India, means a country which share its boundary with the India are called neighbors, and we have learned their names also. So what are the countries? The north west, there is Afghanistan and Pakistan. To the north, there is China and Nepal. In northeast, there is Bhutan. And in east, there is Myanmar and Bangladesh. We have seen the map also. So what are the seven countries which are the neighbors of India? Pakistan, Afghanistan, China, Nepal, Bhutan, Bangladesh, and Myanmar. These are the seven countries which are the neighbors of India. Then we have learned about the islands. We have seen Maldives is situated on the southwest. Sri Lanka is situated on south. Here is the Sri Lanka, which is situated on the south, and Indonesia on the south east. Here we are seeing Indonesia is in the south east. Today we are going to learn about the location of India. So where is India is located? India is located in the south of the continent of Asia. So children, you have learned about the continents in the third class. So I will give you a quick recap. What is continent? Continent is a landmass separated from each other by the oceans. Means it is a large landmass separated from other land masses by the oceans. So here you can see a map. Here different continents are there. Children, tell me how many continents are there. Very good. There are 7 continents. Here you can see a different continents which is separated from each other by the oceans. That's why they called continents. Here is North America, South America, Europe, Africa, Antarctica, Asia, and Australia. These are the 7 different continents. And here you can see Asia, where India is located. And India is located in the south. Here you can see, this is the India which is located in the south of the continent of Asia. Again, here you can see, this is the map of Asia continent. So different areas are there, like North Asia, Central Asia, West East Asia, East Asia, and Southeast Asia. And here is the South Asia where India is located. Asia is the largest of the 7 continents. You have seen in the map that Asia is the largest among the 7 continents. Now, the northern part of India is surrounded by the land, and the south part of the India is surrounded by the water of 3 sides. You can see in this map that northern part, this is the northern part which is surrounded by the lands, and this portion is the southern part which is surrounded by the water on 3 sides. You can see this area is surrounded by the water by the 3 sides, 1, 2, and 3. It has the Indian Ocean on the south, the Arabian Sea on the west, and the Bay of Bengal on the east. Here you can see in the map that Arabian Sea is on the west direction. Bay of Bengal is on the east direction, and the Indian Ocean is on the south direction. Now, next our point is physical features. So what are the physical features of India? India is a land of vastly varied landforms. You know that, such as plains, hills, mountain, deserts, plateaus, along coastline, forest, and islands. These are known as physical features of the land. So a large number of rivers flow through the land, such as Ganga, Brahmaputra, Godavari, Krishna, Narmada, and Mahanadi. So what are the rivers which flow through the land? Ganga, Brahmaputra, Godavari, Krishna, Narmada, and Mahanadi. These are the rivers which flow through the land of India. So, on the basis of physical features, India can be divided into five main regions. Means, according to the different landforms, India is divided into a five main regions. These are the five main regions according to the landforms which is found in India. And we know that what are the landforms? The different features which cover the earth's surface of India, they are called landforms. So, according to that, the regions are here: Northern Mountains, Northern Plain, Deccan Plateau, the Coastal Plains and Island, and Western Desert. Here you can see in this map, so these area is the Northern Mountain, because here the mountain range were found here, and this is the Northern Plain areas because here the earth surface is plain. Here is the Deccan Plateau. These areas are Deccan Plateaus, and these areas are coastal, plain and islands, because here the islands were found here, and Western Deserts. And here you can see the, this is the direction of west, and here the deserts were found, and so these regions are known as Western Deserts. And we have learned about the names of rivers which flow through the lands of India. Like here you can see, that is Ganga, Yamuna, Narmada, Godavari, Krishna. These are the rivers, and some others rivers also flow through the lands of India. Our next topic is states and union territories. Children, India is a huge country and it is divided into 28 states and 8 union territories. How many states are there? Very good. There are 28 states, and how many union territories are there? Very good. There are 8 union territories found in India. And India is a huge country, so it is not possible for a single government to look after the entire country properly. So that is why Indian government work in different level. So Indian government is work in a different level, and there are two main levels of government, that is central government and state government. These are the two main government of India. And what is central government? In India, there is a central government to govern the entire country. So central government have the powers to make law for entire country. And what is the function of state government? Each state have its own state government, and it have the powers to make law for its own state only. And the union territories are directly governed by the central government. Means the power of the union territories is in the hand of central government. Means here the law can be made by the central government. So what is the difference between the state and union territories? In the state, it have its own state government which have its powers to make its law, and in union territories it is directly governed by the central government. So children, now you know that there is 28 states. So children, what are the names of 28 states? If we see the alphabetically, then first is Arunachal Pradesh, Assam, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Goa, Gujarat, Haryana, Himachal Pradesh, Jharkhand, Karnataka, Kerala, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Nagaland, Odisha, Punjab, Rajasthan, Sikkim, Tamil Nadu, Telangana, Tirupuram, Uttar Pradesh, Uttarakhand, and West Bengal. These are the 28 states of India. Let's see the map where these states are located in the map. If you see in the map, so what are the states of India? Himachal Pradesh, Punjab, Uttarakhand, Haryana, Uttar Pradesh, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Bihar, Chhattisgarh, Telangana, Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh, Tamil Nadu, Kerala, Odisha, Jharkhand, Sikkim, here you can see Assam, Meghalaya, Mizoram, Manipur. Here is the Nagaland, Arunachal Pradesh. So all these are the 20 states. Tirupura, all these are the 28 states of India. Next, we will see what are the union territories of India. So children, how many union territories are there? Very good. There are 8 union territories of India. What are they? Andaman and Nicobar, Chandigarh, Daman and Diu, Dadar and Nagar Haveli, Delhi, Jammu and Kashmir, Ladakh, Lakshadweep and Pondicherry. So these 8 are the union territories of India. Let's see in the map where they are located. If we see in the map, so what are the union territories? Now Jammu and Kashmir is also now union territory. Ladakh, Delhi, Chandigarh, Dadar, Nagar Haveli and Daman and Diu are the union territories. Lakshadweep is the union territory. Pondicherry is the union territory. So how many union territories we have mentioned? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And 8th one is Andaman and Nicobar is the 8th union territories of India. So children, for today your homework is you have to learn all the names of states and the union territories and in the map where they are located. Thank you.